Oh, one of the boys is hooked up, yeah. That could be the one, that could be the one, boy. Well, they're snappers, boys, they're nice ones, eh? Well, today we're just all about going out and catching some quality eating fish. How to catch them, care for them, and prepare them. I've got a couple of guys along to help. They've got some different theories on how we're going to do this today. So between the three of us, we should all learn something. Hello. Okay, now I've just missed the school of bait fish, so I've actually paused my sounder. Now if I zoom in on my plotter here, if I touch that school, it's going to give me a new point. And we'll make it that one there, and now it has shown me exactly back where that school was, and I can just get the sounder back up to speed and find my way back to where that school of baitfish was. Okay, go to the bottom, eh? Good boy. There you go. That's how the system works. Nice bait. I'll take care of that for you. Bait, and then we'll be into it.
Yep.
Yep, swing him over. I'll grab one. Radio, we're making bait, boys. We're making bait.
Yep.
Got him?
Got him.
Bring him home. Bring him home.
He's a big donk. Good max for kingies.
Right, that'll do us, I think, men. We're not eating those, all right? That doesn't count towards your quality eating fish. Oh, here we go, there's a bit of sign there. Deploys the sea anchor. Those guys are here for the same reason as us. Well, maybe slightly different reason. They're after the same thing, although they're here to monetize it. Fair enough, you know, they're here doing the job. Actually got not too many problems at all with snapper long lining. It's hook and line, selective. Great way to have the fish harvested, really. Do you want to start with your cane, say? Well, with Scott on the bait and Shay using the Lacanus, we go for one of these guys, a Trigger X soft bait. Right, well, just while I'm waiting for my Trigger X soft bait to sink 15 metres down to the bottom, where hopefully there'll be a snapper, I better explain what we're doing here today. Now, we've got Shay here from Hunting and Fishing New Zealand. He is going to be fishing with the Lacanus jig he started with. Scott, our traditionalist here, he's on the baits. However, they're both charged with doing exactly the same thing, which is catching some quality eating fish. And just to make things more interesting and to keep you on your game, boys, this bin over here, Shay, this one is yours. Scott, this is yours. They're both exactly the same size. Just a nice size. There's ice in there. If you could fill those up with some quality eating fish, it doesn't matter what they are, so long as we can eat them. That is the name of the game.
Yep, got that.
Which is just a... Oh, hang on. Sorry, guys. I'm just, you know, beginner's luck. Hopefully it's an edible fish. Whose bin is this one going to go into? It's reasonable, eh? Okie doke. Oh, they're just the ones we like. Well done, mate. Thank you.
Perfect.
That is perfect, ain't it, Scott? Given I caught it on a lure, technically it should be going into Shay's bin. Scott, pick
Very
your game
good.
Up.
Very good.
Now, what's your co-pupper with the first fish?
It's in the bin. I'm not out here for a suntan.
There we go. Of course, my Trigger X soft bait's good to go again. Hopefully for another one of those. I'm just going to take my knife and give this guy the icky treatment, and he will make some fantastic eating. Okay, okay, fellas. Looks like I've broken the ice. Well, pretty shortly I'll be breaking that bag of ice open. Games begin. What am I on? That could be the one. That could be the one, boy. Well, the snappers, boys, they're nice ones, eh?
Woo!
with the sun coming up, coming up, approaching slack tide, everything sort of seems to be dead in the bay, sort of body of water, and what I like is a bit of tidal flow. So to get tidal flow, I'm going to have to head out of the bay to some deep water, probably perhaps even as deep as 100 metres, guys.
Sweet ass.
So, yeah, we'll maybe drop some jigs, could be some kingies out there, snappers, maybe even hooker. Some quality eating fish anyway, hopefully. It's looking much better out here already before we've even dropped the bait. The Freno's telling me that there's bait fish down there. It's a nice pin that comes up here. If we look at this data box, I'm just going to block out our position. But you will notice one thing, 17.72 sea surface temperature. Back in the bay there, it was only 16.2. So that warmer water, at this time of the year when the fish are looking to spawn, they're looking for warmer water for a better survival rate for their eggs. So they're more likely to be out here. Stand by, guys, we're on some kingy sign. Stand by with that jig.
Standing by.
Okay, go.
Go, 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 man.
70 to 40?
Yeah.
I've got two circle hooks, really lovely looking Teflon coated circle hooks with a bit of cooter on, and I'm getting steadily hammered by small fish.
Yeah. There he goes. He's got him, he's got him.
Those bloody mechanicals, eh?
Not a very big fish, eh? But he might be in our eating range. You know, with the kingfish, you know, those big, beautiful 20, 30 kilo ones, fantastic fighting fish, fantastic sport fish. Of course, you love to catch them. But the ones I really like to eat, probably in that sort of 80 centimetres to 90 centimetres seem to be the, you know, get a really nice fillet off of them. This one might even be too small for that, but it's a kingy nonetheless.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm getting pretty puffed. Not a monster, but good fight nonetheless.
It's nice to have a bend in a rod though, isn't it?
Oh, I tell you what, it's been a few hours coming.
Oh, he might just be in our eating range. It's a little bit bigger than what I thought, well done mate.
Well, we'll lift this fella in and we'll see what happens.
Nice.
That's what the beginner.
Beautiful. Good fish.
Well, now I'm just looking at the size of your bin and I think it might have answered our question. Maybe this is a little bit big, eh?
Are we going to keep him?
No, I think he's a bit big. Oh no, there's some conjecture going on already.
Palpitations.
Look, you can see how skinny he is through here. He's a long fish. I mean,
lovely fish.
Give that fish a chance to put on some condition and he's going to go 20 kilos.
That's a powerful argument.
I mean, well, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what you or I think. No. This is the man that caught it. What do you want to do?
It's going back.
It's going back. Okay, mate. Well, how about we get a photo of you with it first? Point the head towards me. Awesome. Oh, don't let him throw you. Okay. And we'll just pop him back in over this side. Well done. Well, if nothing else, it's going to boost team morale. Nothing like a big kingfish to kick things off for us. And away he goes. Well done, bro. Oh, there he goes. And what a trained one. He goes straight for the underwater cameraman.
Woo!
Yeah. Oh, yeah, some marks here coming up. That bait's just pushed right up there. And generally with kingfish, well with any sort of fish, the higher they move in the water column, the more aggressively they're feeding. Oh yeah, right up, right shallow. They're right shallow, yep. Go, 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 go. Only about 40 metres down too this time, mate. So sort of do your jig from 50 to 30 even, and you should get them.
Yep.
Yep.
There you go.
This one's a bit smaller.
It's not a bad thing we could do with one smaller, because remember this is all about, you know, getting some quality eating fish in that bin of yours there, mate. So smaller would be nice. It's gonna move. Okie doke. Big blue shark, are you alright? You wanna just jump in, mate? Just come back to the boat. Okay, Blair's got a shark after him, mate. Well, I mean, it's a blue shark and they're not aggressive, but they are dumb. This is the shark.
He's real friendly.
Yeah. He would have come up after this kingfish, so he could be a bit fired up as I make the blue shark. Okay, right. Another skinny one, not quite as big as the last one. Not that much fight in them either, you know, like, just because they're swimming skinny. Oh, maybe that's because you dominated. Sorry, mate. What do you want to do this time, mate?
Nah, chuck it back.
Oh, I can just see the anguish.
Anguish, pure pain. No anguish in that, just agony.
You know the way to sort that out, Scott?
Yes.
Is catch one yourself, then you get to decide. It is a very valid argument. Do we keep a fish and do we release it? But you can catch a magnificent fish like that. You can get a photo for the record. You can have a heck of a lot of good time by making absolutely zero impact on the environment. So there's whole industries around the world built on sport fishing where income is generated for a local economy, yet they're taking very few fish. So let that one rip, and that there is that whole process in motion. However, the other side of it, got my man Scott over here. Well, what we're all trying to do is catch a feed of fish, and you can do both side by side. Well, as we are now.
You get some good footage?
Yeah, I almost had to push him away, but not quite.
Okay, stand by with that live bait, Scott. Yeah, go, guys. Don't give up on your baits yet, they've worked for centuries.
Got him.
Come on, is this going to be the correct size? It might be actually. 75 centimetres and it'll do us. Oh, I don't know, I think he might be one for the bin. Oh, nut. Do we measure him? Scott's going, please be 75. He is in fact 80. Far out, I can't believe that, that's big enough, but it is.
Oh.
Tucker?
Yep.
Tucker.
Done.
Okay, well now that Shay's decided we're going to take this fish, the thing is to kill it as quickly and humanely as possible, and an important part of that preparation is to get it straight onto ice. Go to the light, buddy, go to the light. There's about three or four marks there. Give that a little go, eh? Whoever they were, the jig's just gone right through them. Yeah, you've just gone through them now, mate, I think. Close enough for them to see that jig though, I reckon.
Yep.
I bloody knew it was kingfish. We're out in the middle of bloody nowhere, we're about to leave. And I said, I reckon they're kingfish. Boom, drop the jig. That is why, you know, this Navnet Fruno TZ Touch, I love it. It's just invaluable. Yes, that's the whole system in full effect right there. It's an icy too, boy. Don't tighten up too much. Oh, he might run you to the ground. This is a real good one, boy. Oh, don't get rubbed off.
I'll put some drag on because otherwise he's not going to stop.
Just keep that fish moving. You've got to keep him moving because he's going to go to ground. Put some thumb pressure on. Because thumb you can let go if you're overkilling it. This is the one we want, bro. And how's that? We were just about to leave here and I said, I reckon that's kingfish. Nice mark. Drop. And I want to see this fish, I want to see it, I want to see it.
Oh, that mechanical man, he's a worry. Showing no mercy, he's been on it all day.
You're getting a little bit back now, eh? Is it still quite tight?
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
It is good.
Because I put a bit of heat on it.
You obviously did, mate. I'm going to get the camera ready. Oh gosh, I didn't jinx it just then, did I? By going to get the camera. Oh, we've already got one here. Oh, we're sweet. Here it is, I can see it. And it's a kingfish. Look at them go, you love that. Just stop there, mate, stop there. Okay.
Woo! What a ripper.
Okay. Oh, this is, I've got a broken thumb too, remember? I might not be able to hold him. Mate! That's a class up again, that one, boy. That's a thumper. Look at that, he's a big old gnarly one. Yeah, he's had a few rough encounters on the reef. I'm just going to put that rag over his eye just to keep him cool. Again, do I have to say it? Look how thrashed that jig is. Not the most expensive jig in the world. In fact, they're not even close, are they, Shay?
Cheap in comparison to a fish like that.
Absolutely. Oh, that's a good one. Here we go. Cover of the next hunting and fishing catalogue. We might as well make the most of this. Hey, he might have been spared. This is a perfectly cylindrical hole and he's got a hole on the opposite side. I wonder if he's met with a Sparrow spear gun. You've got a healed up scar here from a spear where it's gone through, and if you look on this side, perfectly round cylindrical wound. Anyway, he survived a spear gun, he survived a hook,
going back.
And he's going home. It's a nice fish, bro. Look at that, he just smokes it.
Good fish.
There you go, a new PB. We've done that 3 times today now. Well, it's very tempting to stay on now that there's a couple of nice kingfish showing up. We've got to stay on task. Quality eating fish, boys. Quality eating fish.
To give Shay and Scott the best possible chance to complete their challenge, we head off to make plans for tomorrow's early start. But now, we know a little more about where to find the fish.
Yep.
Rightio, the first order of the day, catching some bait. There he goes. System's working so far. Okay, here we go now, here we go. Get him in the net because, I think what we'll find is that's a quality eating fish that you've just caught there. However, it's also a quality bait.
Just trolling some soft plastics for some cowhai, and of course being an edible fish, but makes great bait as well. Yep.
Just wind slowly in, Scott, and you should get a bite. Okay. Beautiful, the double hook up, that's what we wanted. Make our bait so we can get out on our spot. Fresh bait, live bait, fun and food. The kahawai. Awesome, eh?
Yep.
Good start to the bait as well. Oh, nice one. They're a neat fish, aren't they? You know the boxing gym I went to, my nickname was Kahawai? And it's not because I'm a spirited small fighter, it's because I bleed like one. Okay, wind them in, guys. Next mission. Right, this is us. Okay, boys, we'll just get that burley cranked right up. We'll see if we can't catch some fish here, right? A few JC birds kicking around here. School of kahawai.
Starting to get a nice bit of tide here.
Starting to?
Just heading out into the...
Is it going that way, is it? Oh, that would be bloody lovely. Okay, it looks like you've got the good side of the boat then, Scott.
Psychic energy swings.
You got him on?
Got him on!
That could be the one, that could be the one, boy. Woohoo! That's a bit of burley, look at that. Going old school.
I actually don't have a lot of confidence in my knot.
In the knot? Yeah. Well, you tied it.
I know, that's the worst thing.
Yeah, out there doing it. Oh, here he goes. Yeah. Oh, mate. Yeah, boy, tighten up on him, Scott. Don't let him go to ground. Yeah, the burley's working. You got 15 kg line on that, Scott, so you can afford to give him plenty. How confident are you in your knots? Oh, look at it, that is a nice one. There we go, these are the ones we like. Well, that bodes well for you, Scott, if you take a look over here, mate. Yeah, it goes the way of the baits.
Yes.
Rocket, I said yesterday, man, I've got a plan. It was just to come out to where this cleaner water is. Look how much cleaner this water is, it's warmer, and that's where these guys are. That's why it's fat. It'll be full of either roe or sperm, and you've got to decide whether that's in the keeping size range. Because it's your call there, bro. Scott, you stay out of it.
No influence.
You get to decide what's happening with the one on your line. And Scott has got a snapper, boys. Ace. Oh, just slide him on over. There we go, Scott. Oh, that's another nice one too. Well done, boys.
They're beautiful fish.
You can take them if you like.
Yeah, I'll chuck them back.
You want to chuck it back? We'll better get moving. We'll hold him up for a quick pick.
Fat ass.
Yeah. All right, beautiful fish.
Smile. Beautiful.
Couple of beautiful things and a couple of ugly things. Okay.
Beautiful.
Sweet.
Okay,
we'll he's going home. There he goes. There he goes. Well done, bro.
Beautiful.
One for the bin. One's going home for our kids. Well, for my kids, you haven't found a woman who wants to breed with you yet.
Our table fish challenge is just starting to heat up and it's about to take some unexpected twists.
Holy, look at him, he's a donkey of a Marco.
So tune in next week to see how Scott and Shay get on harvesting and then preparing some quality eating fish.
Moment of truth.
you know, we've got there.
Nothing in it.
It's going home. And that's probably quite a good point there too, releasing that fish. To save you writing me a letter, in fact, a wet hand is just as good as using a wet towel. In fact, in the research that's been done, the things that affect fish mortality are the amount of time that's spent out of the water. Obviously, the longer that they spend out of the water, the more chance they've got of dying. And using a small hook is more likely to kill a fish than anything. So that fella there, don't worry about it, it's gonna be fine. A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.